Welcome everyone. My name is Mark DeJong, and in this video, we will begin to explore the history of the trumpet in jazz. The early days of jazz trumpet are enshrouded in mystery, as one of its very first practitioners never recorded. Buddy Bolden, also known as King Bolden, was born in 1877 in New Orleans, and according to personal accounts from musicians of the day, had a totally individualistic style and bombastic approach that left listeners in awe of his playing. Stories about him describe the power of his sound as legendary. And while playing at the infamous Funky Butt Hall, his trumpet was said to be heard from several blocks away. Soon, other New Orleans trumpeters followed in his path, including Freddie Keppard, Bunk Johnson, and the next trumpet king, Joe King Oliver. Yet, without a doubt, the most important trumpet player to emerge from the early decades of the 20th century was the musician who became known around the world, lovingly referred to as Pops. I'm speaking, of course, of the great Louis Armstrong. Armstrong was born in New Orleans on August 4, 1901. After a brief dust-up with authorities as a youth, he attended a boarding school where he was encouraged to join the band. He chose the cornet as his instrument, and in just a few years, he already had the opportunity to replace Joe King Oliver in Kid Ory's well-known New Orleans band. The following year found Armstrong playing regularly on Mississippi River boats, including a two-year stint with the Fate Marabelle Dance Orchestra. Then in 1922, he was invited to join King Oliver's Creole Orchestra in Chicago, with whom he played and recorded for 2 years. To hear Armstrong and Oliver in action together, check out their 1923 recording of Dippermouth Blues. In 1924, Armstrong moved to New York, where he joined the Fletcher Henderson Orchestra, at that time one of the top bands on the entire East Coast. He is said to have influenced everyone who played with him in that group, from Coleman Hawkins to arranger reedman Don Redman. During the Henderson years, Armstrong also made essential recordings with vocalists, including Ma Rainey and Bessie Smith, with whom he recorded the landmark St. Louis Blues. From 1925 to 1928, Armstrong would make the records that would change music history. His recordings with his Hot Five and Hot Seven groups would set a new high mark for trumpet virtuosity, soloist expression, swing feel, and improvisational mastery. His new benchmark for rhythm and feel would set the tone for jazz throughout the 20th century and even beyond. Armstrong continued to tour and perform around the world until just before his death in 1971. He appeared in numerous films, television shows, radio broadcasts, and he enjoyed top-selling recordings, including 1964's Hello Dolly, which knocked the Beatles from their number one spot on Billboard's Top 100. His biggest chart successes include duets with the legendary singer Ella Fitzgerald and his 1967 recording of What a Wonderful World, which became a posthumous hit for him as part of the soundtrack to Good Morning Vietnam. I've invited Edmonton, Alberta trumpeter Joel Gray to demonstrate Potato Head Blues, which is an Armstrong original that he first recorded in 1927 with his band, the Hot Seven. Here is Potato Head Blues. Next, we will examine the trumpet player whose nickname was Little Jazz. His real name, of course, was Roy Eldridge. Born in Pittsburgh in 1911, Eldridge came from a musical family and was originally inspired by trumpeters Rex Stewart and Red Nichols. Next, he explored the solos of tenor saxophone giant Coleman Hawkins. For example, Eldridge himself described memorizing Hawkins' solo on Stampede from the Fletcher Henderson Band recording from 1926. Eldridge then moved to New York in 1930 and quickly became a regular at various jam sessions around town, establishing himself as a first-rate improviser who could play at breakneck tempos. He then came under the influence of Louis Armstrong. He learned from Armstrong by listening to his recordings, and he learned the importance of telling a story with his horn. He would then go on to record with Billie Holiday before joining the Fletcher Henderson Band in 1935, soon becoming Henderson's feature soloist on tunes like Christopher Columbus. In 1936, he would co-lead an octet along with his brother Joe for a time, before going on to join the Gene Krupa Orchestra, and later the Artie Shaw Orchestra, before resuming playing in small bands. In the years following the end of the war, he toured as a regular member of Norman Grand's Jazz at the Philharmonic, alongside such legendary names as Ella Fitzgerald, Oscar Peterson, and Charlie Parker. Eldridge was also an inspiration to many young trumpeters and musicians who came after him, not the least of which was the young John Burke's Dizzy Gillespie. Eldridge had been a dominating force at jam sessions for years, and Gillespie was known to have said that it was his goal to try and best Eldridge at a jam session. I've invited Calgary trumpeter Andre Wickenheiser to demonstrate a tune recorded by Eldridge and Oscar Peterson called Little Jazz, which is a tune based on the changes to I've Got Rhythm by George Gershwin. Here is Little Jazz.